Nifty slipped nearly 1% to close at 10,855 after the RBI rate cut. Interest rate cut by 35 basis points, much ahead of expectations. RBI reduced growth forecast to below 7% for FY20 amidst concern over the economic growth. This had a negative impact on the market. 10-year G-Sec yield gained by 2 basis points to 6.36% from the intraday low of 6.27%. Moreover, political issues over JNK and poor quarterly results and continued FI selling, and it has dampened the market sentiment. Among the global market, European stocks rallied and US future rebounded from the low on account of impressive quarterly results. Asian market declined marginally after recovering from the low. Metal, auto and PSU banks were major losers today. Select tech, media and metal pharma stocks gained. India Bullion Index slipped 13% to close at 445. Company announced poor Q1 results. RBL Bank nose dividend 8% to close at 52 low at 363. Concern over poor results and poor asset quality. So when we look into the technical, Nifty index failed to surpass the previous day high and fell down towards 10,835 level. It formed an inside bar as traded in the trading range of last session and wiped out the hope of short-term stability. It remained highly volatile and abrupt movement throughout the session, even after the RBI's 35 basis point rate cut and formed a bearish candle on a daily scale. So major trend of the market is in pressure on bonds are being sold, which suggests weakness to continue till immediate hurdle is not surpassed with a follow up buying momentum. But when we look into FIA and Pro in the option side, they have purchased more than 1 lakh contracts. So it shows some kind of positiveness and bullishness in the market. Now it will remain below 10,950 zone. Weakness could persist to track down towards the swing low of 10,780 and then fresh decline towards 10,700 to 10,650 zone. But while hurdle is seen at 10,950, then the 11,000 zone. So 11,000 zone, now it is going to be a bit tough. Only the follow-up buying can improve the market. So when we look into our delivery-based buying, still State Bank is a good buy around this level, the target of 420. Then NCC is good by around this level. Happy trading.